Salvage hunters are an odd breed, hunting down the weird and the wonderful. But they're nothing compared to the legendary British hoarder.
This week we've set ourselves a challenge of going to see some hoarders, collectors, eccentrics, whatever you want to call them. God love them, we need them. They don't really want to sell anything, and they never want to sell anything, but they've got plenty to sell. And these guys, the one thing that knits them together is the fact that they absolutely adore what they're collecting. They really, really do. I'm sure they'll sell me something.
Drew and his sidekick Julian set out on a five-hour drive to Dorchester to lock horns with their first hoarder, Geoff Tite.
Scrapyard's been here 60-odd year, so took it over from his father. He's 89, so he's getting on a bit, but he's all right. He comes out and does a few things.
Hello.
How you do?
I'm Drew.
Yeah, I'm Geoff.
Geoff, this is Jules.
Yeah, how you do?
Hello, Geoff.
This place looks really promising.
There's a few cars growing the brambles there.
Geoff's yard is full of cars and vans, but some of them have been there so long, identifying them is impossible. This is clearly not going to be straightforward for Drew.
Some Studebakers.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Been there a couple of years. There's something Fader collected years ago. He's always liked things like that.
Well, there's two in there, is there?
Where there is, yeah. There's one behind as well.
Blimey, they've been there a while, haven't they?
The American Classic can be worth as much as £12,000 if fully restored. This one is worth a bit less.
No, I'm going to take him, Jules. Get him on the van.
Yeah, load him up.
I'll get a shovel. Take him out.
There's a werewolf next door.
Oh, that's fine.
He won't come out till after dark, if you're right.
We'll go around the other side. There's just so much stuff here. It's just, and it's been here an awful long time.
Drew thinks he's spotted a gem, an early 20th century wrought iron gate.
Is there another gate to go with this, Geoff? It's just the one of these gates here. Do you know where there's another one? Where the other one is?
No, I think it must be just that one, I think.
That's a shame.
But half of it is missing, and he moves on. Even Drew is struggling, but then his salvage hunter instinct kicks in, and he spots something that could potentially make this trip worthwhile.
It's all his staddle stone.
These mushroom-shaped stones probably date from the 18th century and were used to elevate granaries and hay racks away from the ground to protect them from vermin. Today, they're very desirable ornaments, and garden designers will pay up to £350 apiece.
There's how many here? One, two.
Drew often finds one or two staddle stones, but Geoff seems to have a large number. This could be a great find.
Quite a few. How many is there? It's about seven now, is there?
Yeah, it must be one, like seven or eight.
These are all for sale, are they?
Yeah, he's sold a few of them, yeah.
Oh, great.
But if Drew wants them, he'll have to deal with Mr. Tite Sr.
Is this the boss?
That's my father, yeah.
Hello there. Hi, Mr. Tite. Drew.
Tite me name and tite me nature.
Yeah. I like the staddle stones you've got. There's quite a few. I think there's probably 12 altogether.
Yeah.
And 10 that I can use.
Yeah.
I think they've got tops and aren't damaged on the bases.
About 225 apiece.
Really?
Yeah, we've got to start up somewhere.
We've got to start somewhere, yeah. Let's start really high.
Take you not too much off.
Yeah. I want to buy all of them, so I need to get the price down as low as I can. What if I said I was going to take 10? Mm. What could you do if I took a big lump of them, a lot of them?
10.
I'd be after quite a discount, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A couple grand.
I was hoping to buy them and buy all of them, everything, for 150 each, which would be 1,500.
Yeah.
I'll pull out as many as I can. If I find more, I'll pay you the same for more of them. Because some are good. Some I'm going to make good money on.
Yeah.
And some aren't so good. Mm. Some have got good tops and some have got no tops at all or a mismatched top. So it would be that. Mm. That sort of money. What do you reckon?
175 apiece.
About 175 apiece. Mm. OK, I'll dig out as many as I can.
Okay.
Good deal. Enjoy that. That's good.
Finally, Drew has a good deal, but old Mr. Tite has a final surprise to let Drew know who's boss.
Cash.
Cash?
Yeah.
I'll see what I can do. I can see what I can do. Have you got a bank nearby?
Nice petrol.
Yeah, OK. We'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
Right. You've got more of a shop in here as well?
Yeah.
Am I all right to have a poke around in here?
Yeah, of course you can.
OK.
Now formally invited, drew Wade's into the house at a full-blown hoarder's den.
Where'd you start?
Very difficult to take in.
God, he collects anything, doesn't he?
How much are these, Mr. Tite? These things, how much are these?
Opaline, or white glass, was popular in the 19th and early 20th century and is increasingly popular with designers of bars and restaurants. These could easily bring around £120 each.
£15 a pair.
Let me give you 30 quid for the pair.
He said he's going to give you £30 for the two of them.
£30?
Yeah, because he said you didn't ask enough.
Oh.
And I've never heard anybody say that about you before.
With the ice well and truly broken, Drew tries his luck with a slice of 50s nostalgia.
Hairdresser's chairs.
Mid-20th century furniture is growing in popularity, and Drew would have no trouble selling a pair like this for around £150.
What do you reckon? How much for these, Mr. Tite?
£40 a pair.
Yeah, they're okay. I think they're quite cool. So, yeah, what'd you say, 40 quid?
Yeah.
Yeah, brilliant.
Drew has taken on his first hoarder and won. But there's no time to gloat as there are several tons of stones that need to be loaded onto the van.
I was just getting warmed up.
The van, as Julian would say, is on its arse, and it really is. I don't think we can get much more in there. It is full. This will throw us over the weight limit.
Glad Drew dropped by. He was a bit of a laugh. He had a bit of a laugh and a joke. Yeah, it's a good time.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10.